Good morning, classmate. Good morning, Miss Gracia. Today we are going to record our second YouTube channel. The main topic is underwater and greenhouse. And to have a short idea, it's about a project of Italian people who try to see the advantages to plant underwater.
Well, the underwater greenhouse is a project operated by Ocean Reef Group called Nemo's Garden. It consists in 5 bubble shapes that are 20 meters underwater off the coast of Noli, Italy. In these 5 bubble shapes, they are growing products, crops like strawberries, lettuce, basil, and beans. It may sound like something straight out of a fictional novel, but it perfectly makes sense. The mix of warm, humid air and the abundant carbon dioxide provide the perfect conditions to the plants to grow. In conclusion, this project is using the natural conditions that the ocean provides to grow plants. The temperatures are constant. The shape of the greenhouse allows to the water to constantly operate, evaporate and replenish the plant. And the last but not less important, the abundant carbon dioxide acts like a steroid that make the plant grow faster. But now we can cite the advantages and disadvantages like everything has.
Well, as now mentioned, we are going to divide the analysis of the text into parts. We are going to talk and discuss about the pros and about in the contrast about the underwater and greenhouse text. So first of all, to define the pro of the project, we need to know that the actual effects of human in the world. As we know, contamination is increased every year, every day, more. So many gases of the human activity are going to the atmosphere, and these contaminate more and more. As we know also, agriculture is one of the most common contaminants in all the world. Not for the use of pesticides, as most of the people know, it's also for the use of animals like cows or pigs that are contaminate the whole world. In a magazine that we read, we can see that the most common contaminants in agriculture are cows and pigs. These animals are produce gases that are the most common in atmospheres, and this reduces the protection of people of the environment. So also another contaminant that have agriculture is the use of pesticides. As we all know, pesticides are chemicals substances that produce these common gases in the atmosphere. But to know more about the use of pesticides in agriculture, we have to know the cycle of pesticides. As a reminder, we're going to talk about a little bit about that. So most of the pesticides that we use in agriculture, we applicate as irrigation. After irrigation, the fields, most of the pesticide is not staying plants. Most of these pesticides is in soil, and this pesticide is not stay in the superficial of soil. Most of this is percolated to the water resource in groundwater. So this groundwater reservation that we have is already contaminated for chemical substances that are pesticides. So it's not a tool that we can use in after, because it's already contaminated. So in the project, it's supposed that we are not going to use pesticides. So that can be an advantage for this project. The use of pesticide is going to reduce, because also it's supposed to underwater we are not going to see any pests or and specific pests for crops. So these are two important advantages that we have. That advantages is going to help to reduce the contamination in the whole world. Also, and the most important for us is that it will be more space to supply the global demand of food. That means, as we already know, also population is growing, and right now in an article said that it's supposed that in 2050 we are going to be 10 billion of people in whole world. So that means that the food that we need to plant to feed all these people is going to increase also. So we need more soil to do that. But the problem is that we don't have more soil. So we need another alternative to produce crops and to produce food to these people. This project and the use of underwater project is a positive alternative that we have. But is it that this underwater plant is going to help to reduce the demand of food? For me and my personal opinion, no, because we are talking about meters and meters of water that we need to plant, because as you can see in the picture of the text, the numbers of plants that are planting are really, really, really short. So I think it's a project that is going to help, but in not in a big percentage, but are going to give us another alternative. And in more studies, maybe we can use and modify.
Well, as Gonzalo say, not everything is pink. Like it has positive things, it has bad things. We think that a bad thing that this project will have is that the impact in the economy of the little agriculturers. As we know, it is a expensive project. Not all the people have access to this project, and less the little agriculturers that are who provide the most of the crop, the food in the world. If we only practice this, we could have a decrease in the economy of the countries and the elimination of all the little agriculturers, and it is a bad thing. Other thing is that we could alter the environment of the species that live in the ocean, because we are altering their habitat, and it could have a effect the extinction of a lot of species. and so we have to take care about that thing.
Well, as conclusion, this project is going to help us to in a lot of points, but I think we need to make more experiments to implement as a real project that is going to help us to increase the demand of food. Also, it's important that every government of each country analyze the actual demand of global food and find a alternative to help this problem. So thanks to watch.
Thanks.